I would like to request Shri Vanya Bhoje, Srimati Vanya Bhoje, Project Officer of Department of IT and Communication, to kindly felicitate the Chief Guest and the dignitaries for today's program on behalf of the Department of IT and Communication. Chairman, to the chairman, please. Thank you, and to the Chief Secretary, ma'am. Now I would like to request Shri Sonam Chombe, Secretary IT, Government of Arunachal Pradesh, for the welcome address, please.
Very good morning to all of you. On behalf of the Department of IT, I welcome the chief guest of today's function, Navam Rendia sir, Honorable Minister, Urban Development, Urban Planning, Urban Local Bodies, Land Management, Law and Justice. Guest of Honor, Honorable Chairman, State Council for IT and Governance, Sri Gabriel Monshuji. Most respected Government Chief Secretary, Madam. Senior Principal Secretaries, Commissioners, Secretaries, Directors and other officers of the State Government, the bankers, the Market Welfare Association, the merchants, media friends and my dear friends. Today we are here to attend the concluding ceremony of the Digi Dhan Mela, which started in Vigyan Bhavan by the Honorable Prime Minister on 25th of December last year, and the Mela has travelled to 100 cities, and even in Itanagar on the 20th of January we held a Digi Dhan Mela, which was a very successful event. So without taking much time, we have a long agenda and we have a very short time, because by 12:30 we will be going live and listen to our Honorable Prime Minister for the concluding ceremony. So without much ado, I once again welcome you all to the concluding ceremony of the Digi Dhan Mela. Thank you very much.
Sir, now may I request Srimati Shakuntala Damani, Chief Secretary Government of Arunachal Pradesh, for setting the agenda, please, ma'am.
Thank you very much. I would first like to, on behalf of the Department of IT, welcome the Honorable Chief Guest, Shri Navam Rendia ji, and also the guest of honor, Shri Gabriel D. Monson, and all the senior officers, bankers, traders. In the course of my interaction with all of you, I think we have discussed the digitization process, which has been probably a very ingrained part of our lives, whether that be in the Department of Education or in the Department of Finance or in trade and commerce or even in citizens' life, farmers' life. So it is all pervasive. So perhaps it's an issue that all of us cannot escape from. Therefore, I think squarely and from the very sort of ab initio, from the day we had the Digi Dhan Mela, we have been flagging this issue that digitization, along with banking outreach, along with Aadhaar and ecosystems, is a reality, is a fact of life which we cannot escape. But perhaps due to certain reasons of low penetration of the highways and the optic fiber network, which is supposedly the backbone of connectivity. Out of the 2000 kilometers, perhaps we have not even laid optic fiber lines, we've got 200 kilometers. So really our sort of presence today in terms of optic fiber network connectivity is only about 10% or maybe even less than that. But nonetheless, I think everybody is using a mobile phone, everybody uses his WhatsApp, and everyone knows how to sort of use a laptop and a computer. So I think we are in the process of equipping ourselves with the modern technology, and this would make a great change in our lives in terms of ushering in knowledge and information. Be that, for example, just to tell you that if we have to strengthen and empower our farmers must not sell their produce, which may be a very high value item in the world global market, but due to lack of connectivity, whether that be road, rail or air, they make a distress sale. But were he to have access to information with the necessary connectivity of air, road and rail, I think the farmer himself would be empowered to sell his produce electronically, establishing contact with some of the exporters and traders. But of course, we still have to cover the gaps of certifying those produce, ensuring that farmers must use modern technologies, inputs into their sort of agrarian sort of farming fields, and also sort of see that certain infrastructures of packaging, cutting, collection, gradation, all that also needs to be done. We are hoping that the organic farming sector for Arunachal Pradesh will be a game changer, for which we would also like to see that digitization must penetrate and must cover the agricultural produce marketing boards. We have a long way to go. We know that we have to take everybody along, and we also have to see that the IT and telecom departments of Government of India must understand the realities of the challenges of the terrain, and also to see that implementing agencies, whosoever that may be, whether that be a contractor or a government agent or a government department, must do it smoothly and must achieve the timelines that has been set for them to lay the optimal end. But notwithstanding that, we should not be silent spectators to what is happening. I think that is the reason we kick-started the digital movement here. And when we did organize the mela, we found that a lot of people were enthusiastic about opening a bank account, having an Aadhaar card, linking it with the Aadhaar, proceeding it with the Aadhaar for their payments. But to begin with, if we can at least electronically transfer our funds to the departments and to the districts, we would have made a big headway and a head start. And we would also, perhaps, if school stipends, scholarships, pensions, and mother and child program like the Janani Suraksha Yojana, where a child born in a government hospital, immediately the mother gets financial help from the Ministry of Health under the Janani Suraksha Yojana program, and the universalization of vaccination also follows suit, which actually saves this child from any vaccine preventable diseases like tuberculosis, diphtheria, pertussis. So everything is so integrated and so connected in terms of digitization that even 6 doses of antigens which the child has to take can be tracked through the biometric system and through the digitized process. Our roads will have better signages, better traffic signals, our CCTV cameras can come, our bank accounts can be linked to our Aadhaar, and there will be no leakages of funds, there will be no diversion of funds, there will be no mistrust amongst us that we are diverting funds, we are not utilizing funds properly, we are not utilizing our funds in the manner that it should be judiciously, and to the concerned beneficiaries and concerned sectors, as the case may be, because our funds, 90% of the funds come from the Government of India. Even our GST, which is uniformly likely to be rolled in the entire country, rolled out in the entire country, we need a digitized infrastructure and a format. Unless we integrate into the system, our tax revenue collection would also fall. So if we were collecting 1,000 crores manually, but today the digitized format where the goods and services tax regime expects that tax collection should be starting at point A, because it's an interstate sale, or it's a transaction, say, at Delhi or at Sadar Bazaar or at some place in, say, the south of India, it has to be tracked digitally. This would mean that if we keep ourselves out, we would not be able to cover the gap. We would take a lot of time in getting our digitization infrastructure into place, our GST regime into place, and our tax collection will fall, and perhaps we would be totally dependent on the center. But if we were to have a digitized format with simultaneous training for the enforcement regime, for the enforcement the officials of the Department of Sales Tax, which is now of course the GST or the VAT department, we would have people who are equipped to inventorize, to collect, know the points of sale. Similarly, if the traders were to have POS machines and if they were to have digitized way of buying and selling, you would be tracking your bank accounts yourself. You would not have to be dependent on your son or on your elders or on a sort of more educated or sort of a person who poses himself as the all sort of arrogating to himself the authority of running your life. You should be able to run your life the way and the manner it should be. So each of us need to be responsible towards sort of ensuring that digitization is a way of life. It's a foregone conclusion that today we cannot avoid this, we cannot delay this. So I would once again like to congratulate the IT department, and particularly I think the championing the cause is our Honorable Chief Minister, who has looked at digitization of the cabinet meetings, digitization of the secretariat, and he himself is very techno-savvy, and of course the parliamentary secretary, and the presence of our Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Navam Revyaji, goes to show that the stamp of approval from the government as far as digitization is concerned is something which we all are willing to do with the collective vision and the vision of the Prime Minister to see that digitization must not be delayed and must be completed in all respects. It's something which we have come here to validate. So thank you very much, Swarnabh and Prince. You have put all your efforts together, all the audience, particularly the officers, the heads of departments, the traders and banks who are here. I would like to thank them for their participation. And I hope all of you become messengers of this digitized culture in the world and make it a reality. Thank you very much.
The conclusion of the month-long Digi Dhan Mela. In fact, information technology has taken various steps and forms in this modern way. And one of the important applications of which has been e-governance. The users of IT in government has ensured accountability, transparency and efficiency, which has seen everywhere where citizen services are becoming better and more improved. A very important aspect of using IT in our lives is also financial inclusion and financial literacy, along with providing citizen services like public inquiries or government-related matters. Digital financial inclusion and literacy is a remarkable initiative and a blessing for citizens of our state to counter the problems as we all face regarding non-availability of cash facilities in our villages, in remote corners or various locations or even at times in our state capital. Also, our citizens are at times not aware of the various schemes and benefits which are being made available to them by the government. And on a stronger imperative, many modes of corruption and financial leakages also occur due to lack of awareness and manual processes, which causes much harm to our people. I consider the initiative towards cashless economy as one of the most important missions of independent India. Today, the people of the country are hit by corruption as much as from under development. Cashless transactions would not only ensure a robust economic growth, but it would also help curb and control financial corruption and leakages. You would remember that on 20th January 2017, the government had organized a digital money mela or the Digi Dhan Mela in the state capital. This was done in conjunction with the many stakeholders like the central government, the National Payments Corporation of India, all the leading banks, IOCL and other corporate entities like e-wallet, e-payment vendors, etc. and estimated footfall of over 20,000 citizens of the state was recorded. The event was well captured by national media and currently stands as one of the best digital fairs in the Northeast. Visitors and customers were able to purchase items only by making digital payment, and various items ranging from foodstuffs to bank accounts to handicraft products, horticultural products, etc. were made available in this fair. The various banks, telecom service providers, village level entrepreneurs working at the common service centers educated the masses about how to use digital mode for making payments and help them in doing so at this unique fair, where all transactions were met cashless. They also set up efficient Aadhaar card stores for applications by recipients, which were a huge success and attracted the large amount of large several crowds in the same cashless. This Mela was organized to change the mindset of the general masses, and this was the first such fair in the state, educating the masses on how to use even mobile phones for making payments. There were also various campaigns and schemes like Lucky Graham Yojana for consumers and Digi Dhan Vyapar Yojana for merchants in order to motivate us all to use digital methods of payment. As we come to the conclusion of this event today, I am very hopeful that the citizens of Arunachal Pradesh got a very wonderful opportunity to know and understand about digital financial inclusion and influence. And I would like to request all the stakeholders, especially the banking sectors, for online banking mode support, and the telecom operators for looking into the connectivity aspect. Fertilizers company needs to come up to spread more awareness among our farmers, and also the specialized IT department to bring all of them on single platform like this to motivate us all to be part of. I would like to take this opportunity to convey my sincere thanks to all for being a part of this great initiative and offer them all the best wishes for making such endeavors in the future as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. Since the Parliament Secretary IT could not make it to today's event due to unavailable circumstances, let us move on to the next event. We have some videos here of Digi Dhan Mela Itanagar chapter to showcase for you. Before that, I would like to highlight some facts about Digi Dhan Mela Itanagar. Digi Dhan Mela Itanagar at the state level was organized on 20th January 2017 at IG Park Itanagar. The chief guest was the Union Minister for Civil Aviation, Sri Ashok Gajapati Raju. And the guest of honor were Minister of State Home, Sri Kiran Rishu, and Sri Jonah Main, Deputy Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh. The program was a grand success for the promotion of digital transactions with over 50 stores of banks, government organizations, and e-wallet companies. The approximate footfall was around 50,000, and over 5,000 digital transactions were recorded during the Mela in a single day worth more than 5 lakhs. Around 2,066 bank accounts were opened and 1,200 Aadhaar cards were made. The Mela also saw an interesting cashless football match between Chief Minister 11 and Press 11. The Tourism Department, Handloom and Textile Department and Department of Agriculture went cashless on the day of the Mela. The Mela was truly a celebration of demonetization, with performances by famous artists like Sri Sutan Singh, who is an Indian Idol finalist. So let us now see a short video displaying the celebration of this momentous cashless digital Mela Itanagar.
Aaj ek sabhi public karyakram Arunachal Pradesh Digi Dhan Mela 2017 shubhakamnaen Shri Ashok Gajapati Raju ji. Thank you. आज के इस बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण समारोह का विधिवत शुभारंभ का संदेश
टीम अरुणाचल का मुखिया सेवा खंड के युवा मुख्यमंत्री काम करने की उत्सुकता के साथ काम कर रहे हम लोग सब साथ हैं मिल करके उसको एक टीम अरुणाचल खंड करके मुख्यमंत्री को समर्थन देते हुए अरुणाचल को ऐसा भरा 15 साल के अंदर में हिंदुस्तान का सबसे आमदनी ज्यादा वाला प्रदेश अरुणाचल को बनाना चाहिए
अरुणाचल प्रदेश शुड ऑल्सो बिकम पार्ट ऑफ दिस ग्रेट एक्सरसाइज टू द बेनिफिट ऑफ इट्स Please exploit the forward-lookingness of our state governments and government of India.
Transactions, data only from the apps and the swipe machine and the POS machine is 351. Number of bank accounts opened in the Mela, this has been a big and so far we have had 371 new bank accounts opened today up to 2 o'clock.
Great moments are born out of great opportunities. This initiative of demonetization of government.
All the banks have been advised that the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, which is a zero deposit bank account, needs to be opened and a helpline or a help desk or an outreach program must be introduced where the deputy commissioners would organize that the lead banks, the bank branches, and where there are no brick and mortar banks, a banking correspondent must ensure that everyone opens an account.
We also
signing of MOU for data digitization of all records between MSPN writer and Department of IT. Now I would like to request Special Secretary IT to give few details about this initiative. Please, sir.
Respected Chief Guest, Shri Nawab Devia sir, Honorable Minister, Government of Arunachal Pradesh, Chairman SCITG, Shri G.V. Mansoor sir, Chief Secretary Madam, Secretary IT, senior officers, commissioners, secretaries, friends from media, participants, students from NIRIST, and all other people, a very good morning to all of you. Last year in the month of August, Honorable Chief Minister took a very important and historic cabinet decision about making a paperless secretariat. These steps for implementing e-office include making digital signatures to enable all officers for digitally signing files. A training of over 500 hours spread across 2 months was conducted of all secretariat officials. NIC accounts were created of all secretariat officials. A massive hardware revamp involving computers, printers, scanners will be procured in the current financial year. And the last leg of completing this dream, of achieving this dream of a paperless secretariat was digitization of the old files, so that new notings can then begin on those files. The last leg today is also being completed on this occasion of digital concluding ceremony by signing the MOU between PN Writers and the Department of IT. The PN Writers is a well-established document management company which is embedded with the Government of India, and we have representatives Sri Ajit and Shailesh from PN Writers to sign the MOU on behalf of the company, and Director IT shall sign the MOU on behalf of the department. After this, any department of government of Arunachal Pradesh shall have full access to the PN Writers to digitize their old records at the dates that have already been finalized. They have a capability of digitizing 1 lakh records per day. So we hope to make a paperless secretariat within this financial year. May I request the Director IT and Sri Ajit MD PN Writers to exchange the MOUs in front of the honorable guests.
Going on to our next Department of IT in collaboration with Department of Audit and Pension has created a centralized management information system for employees and pensioners of Audit and Pension Department. The pension is one of the most important parts of a government employee's life. This initiative will make the life of these esteemed pensioners very easy. In this context, I would like to request Director Audit and Pension for a brief presentation. Please, sir.
Good afternoon to all. Honorable Chief Guest, Honorable Guest of Honor, respected Chief Secretary, respected Commissioner, Secretaries, and other dignitaries present. This is an IT initiative on pension sector. Let me straightway go on the subject. I take the opportunity to place before you in nutshell about pension and what it is. Just about the pension, the types of pension, superannuation pension, retiring pension, invalid pension, pension on absorption to water loss bodies, compensation of pension, compulsory retirement pension, and political pension. In case of death of a government servant, during in harness or after retirement, family pension comes and the eligible person such as spouse of deceased government employee, unemployed and unmarried sons up to the age of 35 years, unemployed and unmarried dependent daughter up to marriage or unemployment, widowed or divorced daughter, dependent parent if deceased government employee was a bachelor and has a family, dependent physically or mentally caring sons or daughter up to their death, then retirement gratuity and death gratuity. This is another kind of pension, that is extraordinary pension, and extraordinary pension due to death while on official duty at higher rate. Extraordinary pension due to death or terrorist attack, anti-social element, etc. at higher rate. Facilities to the pensioner. A pensioner can draw pension from any treasury or designated public sector advertising bank from anywhere in India at their desire, including Nepal. Our pensioners, a good number of pensioners are settled in Nepal, and they are getting their pension from Nepal. Now what we are doing, pension payment order is issued directly to the treasury officer inside Arunachal Pradesh. Pension payment order is issued to accountant general of other states payable for treasury if pension are settled outside Arunachal Pradesh. Challenges before us, timely issue of pension. The revision of pension from time to time due to increased DNS allowance, operations of pension, revisions of pay on pay commission recommendations, grievance redressals. Pensioners are settled all over India, including Nepal. Many a times, their pension is not correctly calculated by treasury and then of increased year revision of pension. So we are receiving complaints from different earners from all over India, and it is our burden and responsibility to redress their complaints. The aims and objectives of this IT initiative, timely issue of pension payment order, the pension payment order, gratuity payment order, and compensation payment order, timely revision of pension, uploading of government orders issued from time to time on pension in website for resolution of pensioners, tracking of pension, settlement of pension by pensioners from their respective places, integration of submission of pension papers by department online, integration of payment of pension online for treasuries and banks, and e-governance together online. This e-governance project initiative on pension shall help issue of pension with accuracy and faster accuracy in compilation of data and accounting and expenditure. This is a step forward and miles to go to achieve the desired result. So this is about, in nutshell, about the cancer, what we are doing. Now, I take the privilege to request the honorable that to launch the Itanagar initiative on creation of centralized management information system for employees and centralized. So,
thank you. This is the entire website. Basically, application is running on the back of the website, which we have some PPT slideshows where you can see the application. This is an internet application. And at the end of the day, when all the files are processed and the pension EPO is generated, we upload their information onto the website. So the pensioners can click on the track file over there. Once clicked, we can search his details by mobile number, by name, and by various other options which are available on that. Please click on the name option. You can write Sinha over there, S-I-N-H-A, and search. Okay, this is the status the pensioner will be able to see on the website, wherein he will be able to see when the file has been received from the pensioner's department in the Directorate of Audit and Pension, the date and the time of receipt, then what is the status of the file, whether the file is processed, and finally, if the file is processed, then the PPO number is generated, that is the pension payment order has been generated. So the pensioner can actually track the status of his file. So this becomes very easy for the pensioners. Rather than going to the department and getting the status of their pension file, they can directly go onto the website and get a real-time status of the pension file on a daily basis. That would be all. Thank you. The web address, Arunachal Pension Portal, gov.in. And we will be also available on the NIC portal very soon. We are working on the shifting of the NIC server. That will be pension.arunachal.gov.in. Thank you.
Respected dignitaries, all the guys, Dr. Dias, and all of present here, very good afternoon to all of you. Taking forward the initiative of cashless transaction, the Department of Information Technology and Communication has collaborated with multiple banks to bring the merchants on board for receiving cashless payments. The merchants were helping opening current accounts, downloading mobile applications, installation of QR machine, and acceptance of other enabled payment systems. It is indeed a great outcome that the merchants have become fully capable of receiving cashless other enabled payment systems from their customers. Today, on the occasion of concluding ceremony of Digi Dhan Mela, we take pride in honoring them. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now we have prize distribution ceremony. I would like to request Chief Guest Sir, Guest of Honor Sir, Chief Secretary Ma'am, and Secretary Sir, kindly keep away the certificates of deduction to the merchant, bank, and the students. So, first, for merchants, merchants category, certificate of recognition goes to MS Samaritan Homi Hospital number 11. MS Samaritan Homi Hospital number 11 in merchant category. Certificate of recognition to the merchant MS Samaritan Homi Hospital number 11. LM Drug House Itanagar. LM Drug House Itanagar. Hotel Paramount Itanagar. Baby Oil Nahardagan. Baby Oil Nahardagan in merchant category. Hotel Park Itanagar. City Loop Distributor. Hotel Kameng. Todo Hotel. MS Arman Enterprise, MS Sangeeta, Mr. Virat Maitre, Mr. Ramesh Prasad, Mr. Dikar Kopiwala, Mr. Taba Meso, Mr. Kasu Paron, Mr. Kasu Paron, Mr. Merchant Category, Certificate of Recognition to the Merchant.
Group A and Group C.
members of Group A are Sri Kavi Ketan, Sri Yagra, and Sri Niro Daram. Yes, third prize, Group A members, for quiz competition. And for Group C, third prize, quiz competition, Sri Bapu Kavin, Sri Sanjeev Kumar, Sri Vinay Pandey. And the winners are from Merit. No, if the winners are from Science and Technology. For debate competition, first prize goes to Sri Ronald Bose. Prize goes to Sri Kisan Moda. Third prize goes to Sri Kartan Lupi. Debate competition. The winners of debate competition. And the next is show video competition. First prize goes to Sri Bhaskar Barwa. Sri Saurav Roy and Sri Nilanjan Das. Short video competition. Winners of short video competition. First prize goes to Sri Bhaskar Barwa. Second prize goes to Sri Saurav Roy and Sri Nilanjan Das. And for slogan competition, first prize goes to Sri Shubham Rai. Second prize goes to Sri Ashish Kumar Mundra. Third prize goes to Sri Abhishek Kumar. Slogan competition winners.
Those things which they have already seen.
Now it is for us to see to it how we make Arunachal totally a cash-free state, cash-less state, and what we should make it one of the most developed states in IT sector. This digitization or IT revolution has brought total transparency, accountability, answerability, which are the basic needs, essence, the essence of any democracy. Corruption will reduce, and we can make India really a vibrant, a corrupted democracy. This occasion, Digi Dhan Mela, coincides with the birth anniversary of the great son of this soldier, Baba Ambedkar, who was a jurist, social reformer, was the chairman of the drafting committee of our constitution. Every student probably knows how the preamble to the Indian constitution grounds and reads. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. The word secularism, secularist, and socialist were probably inserted during the 42nd constitutional amendment under Mrs. Gandhi. How it reads, justice, social, economic, political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, hate, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all. Pradesh, why I am saying, because the students should know, they should mark up this preamble to the constitution. Fraternity as being the dignity of the individual and unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, to hereby adopt in a gift to our service occasion. Gift of Dr. Ambedkar. We study who came from a deformed community called Sedu Kashi, considered to be untouchable at that time, those days. He suffered all through his life the humiliation. The first law minister who got his education from Columbia University and London School of Economics and rose to become the chairman of the drafting committee of our constitution. The largest democracy in the world, we Indians are all proud of. Ambedkar was always opposed to caste system. Throughout his life, he fought for abolition of caste system. He was opposed to Article 370, the status that is given to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Therefore, this is a great occasion to recall the contribution, the great contribution made by this great man. The same in India, in some parts of the country and in some societies, the caste system still prevails, which is very unfortunate. We fortunately in Arunachal, we don't have that caste. More fortunate people in the country. I think all of you will be interested to hear from the Prime Minister today, Narendra Modi. As I say, Arunachal is also catching up with the rest of the country, and we should go ahead. I must really thank and congratulate the Department of IT for having taken this initiative and for having made this event a grand success. Congratulations to all the prize winners, and let us lead up to the expectations of the society by creating in letter industry the principle of this Digi Dhan Mela and also the IT revolution going on in the country. Once again, I thank the organizers for having invited me to attend this very important conclusion function of security. Thank you very much.
Now we have national telecast on Digi Dhan Mela closing ceremony. We have speech from the Honorable Prime Minister of India.
The nation is not moving from cashless economy to cashless or cashless economy.
I think it's the end of today's.
Chairman, SCIT, GD Mansuri, Chief Secretary Madam, Secretary IT, Commissioners and other senior officers present in the gathering, friends from the media, banks, merchants, the ambassadors of the Digi Dhan message, and dear students. It is indeed a proud privilege on this occasion that culminates the celebration of 100 Milas held in 100 cities. On this historic moment, I would like to propose the vote of thanks to the chief guest and the chairman for taking out time to attend this function and guiding us and inspiring us, for also placing their faith in the Department of IT and the government machinery to be able to take forward this initiative in collaboration with the banks. I would like to place on record a special gratitude for our Chief Secretary Madam, who has always encouraged us and led the way. She has always shown us how to do things practically and how to achieve the desired results. I also like to thank our Secretary IT, who has been leading the department and encouraging us to take innovative and encouraging initiatives to achieve the desired results. I also thank the banks, especially the lead bank and the lead bank manager, Sri Jaswal Singh, for helping us in organizing the merchants and getting them on board. My heartiest thanks and congratulations to all the ambassadors who have taken forward this message of Digi Dhan Mela and truly helped us make it a reality. I also thank the media, who play a great role in spreading this message far and wide amongst the masses. Finally, a word of thanks is also in order to the officers and the staff of the Department of IT as well as the district administration Itanagar Capital Complex, who have made this event possible by organizing all the logistics and the videos in a short time frame. Let's not forget that this culmination is not the end, it is just the beginning. It is the beginning to make services faceless, cashless and paperless, thereby making India a...
Abdullah, be rampant. विवाद करने के बाद भी लोग स्वीकार करते गए तो बात खान पर विवाद करने में लगे हुए हैं, वो उनका काम है, करते रहेंगे। आपके पास मोबाइल फोन ही हो या ना हो, आपका अगर आधार नंबर है, आप स्वयं किसी दुकानदार के यहां गए हैं और उसके पास छोटा सा इंस्ट्रूमेंट होगा, बड़ा पॉश मशीन की भी जरूरत नहीं होगी, छोटा सा ही होगा, 2 इंच बाय 2 इंच का, वो आपका अंगूठा वहां लगवा देगा और उससे अगर आपका पहले से बैंक के साथ आपका आधार नंबर जुड़ा हुआ है, अगर आपने 10 रुपए का माल लिया है तो 10 रुपए आपका ऑटोमेटिक कट हो जाएगा, 1 रुपया साथ में ले जाने की जरूरत नहीं, कहीं आपका कारोबार रुकेगा नहीं। कितनी उत्तम व्यवस्था की दिशा में हम जा रहे हैं और इसलिए आज भीम आधार एक ऐसा रोजन और हम आप देखा जी वो दिन दूर नहीं होगा दुनिया की बड़ी बड़ी यूनिवर्सिटीज इस भीम आधार का टेस्ट नहीं करेंगे, भारत तक पर आएगी, सारे नौजवान तरी करेंगे, दुनिया में आर्थिक बदलाव क्या हो सकता है कि इसका यह आधार बनने वाला है, ये रेफरेंस पॉइंट बनने वाला है। और मैं कभी हमारे रविशंकर जी को कहता था क्या भारत सरकार ने इसका पैटर्न करवाया नहीं करवाया है, क्योंकि होने वाला दुनिया इस विषय को अपना विषय बनाने के लिए, मुझे अभी अफ्रीकन देशों के जितने मुखिया लोग मिले तो उन्होंने मेरे से इसकी जिज्ञासा भी की और ये भी चाहता कि हमारे देश के लिए आप कर सकते हैं क्या, धीरे धीरे इसका वैश्विक विस्तार का कारण भी बन सकता है और भारत एक बहुत बड़े कैटेगरी के देश के रूप में काम कर सकता है। इस डिजी धन योजना के तहत हिंदुस्तान के 100 अलग अलग शहरों में कार्यक्रम किए गए, लाखों लोगों ने बढ़ चढ़ करके हिस्सा लिया, टेक्नोलॉजी को समझने का प्रयास किया, स्वीकार करने का प्रयास किया, अब बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में लोगों को इनाम मिले और आज जिन लोगों को इनाम मिला उसमें से एक सज्जन चेन्नई के, उन्होंने तो घोषणा कर दी मुझे जो इनाम मिला है वो मैं गंगा सफाई के लिए समर्पित कर देता हूं, मैं उनका अभिनंदन करता हूं। और वैसे भी डिजी धन सफाई अभियान ही है, भ्रष्टाचार काले धन के खिलाफ लड़ाई का एक बहुत बड़ा माध्यम रहा। और मैं देशवासियों को कहना चाहता हूं, कम कैश विचार आपको पसंद आए या ना आए, कैशलेस सोसाइटी का सपना आपको अच्छा लगे या ना लगे, नोटों के बिना जिंदगी कैसे गुजरेगी आपके मन में सवाल या निशान हो या ना हो, लेकिन इस देश में कोई ऐसा इंसान नहीं होगा जिसके दिल दिमाग में भ्रष्टाचार के प्रति गुस्सा ना हो, देने वाला भी गुस्सा करता होगा और कभी लेने वाला भी रात को जाकर के सोचता होगा यार मोदी आया है कहीं फंस जाऊंगा तो क्या। बहुत बुरा हुआ है लेकिन आगे बुराई से बचने के लिए एक उत्तम साधन है। जो भी भीम आधार के सहारे आगे बढ़ना मदद करेंगे मेरी वो एक प्रकार से भ्रष्टाचार और काले धन की लड़ाई लड़ने के सिपाही हैं, मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ी ताकत है। और इसे मैं इसे निमंत्रित देता हूं नौजवान, और इसमें 2 नई चीजें जोड़ी है इस बार, और अभी तो योजना यह है कि वो 14 अक्टूबर तक हम चलाएंगे, आज 14 अप्रैल है, 14 अक्टूबर इसलिए कि 14 अक्टूबर को बाबा साहब आंबेडकर ने दीक्षा दी थी। बाबा साहब आंबेडकर का दीक्षा का वो पवित्र अवसर था, 14 और इसके आज 14 अप्रैल से 14 अक्टूबर तक एक विशेष योजना है। आज देखा होगा आपने अच्छे परिवार के नौजवान भी उनके दिमाग में भी है कि हम वैकेशन में कुछ से कुछ काम करें और खुद कमाई करें। धनी परिवार के बच्चे भी अपनी पहचान छुपा करके ऐसी जगह में जाते हैं और ऐसे काम करते हैं, खुद को ट्रेन करना काम है। जिस सत्र में पारा हुए वहां वो मौका नहीं पड़ता, वो होटल में जाते हैं, बर्तन साफ करते हैं, चाय परोसते हैं, इस प्रकार के काम करते हैं, कई पेट्रोल पंप पे जाकर काम करते हैं। एक गर्व से जीने का आज नई पीढ़ी का दिमाग में ये चीजें आ रही। पहले हम सुनते थे विदेश में नौजवान सब रात को जाकर के दो दो तीन घंटे ऐसी मेहनत का काम करते हैं, टैक्सी कमाते हैं, जितना करते हैं कमाना करते हैं, उस कमाई करते हैं और फिर पढ़ते रहते हैं। आज हिंदुस्तान में ये चीज आई है, ऐसा नहीं है, हमारा ध्यान नहीं है। इस भीम आधार के तहत मैं इस वैकेशन में मैं मेरे देश के नौजवानों को निमंत्रित करता हूं। इसमें एक योजना है रेफरल, या अगर आप किसी को भीम ऐप के संबंध में समझाएंगे, किसी मर्चेंट को समझाएंगे, किसी नागरिक को समझाएंगे, उसके मोबाइल पर भीम ऐप डाउनलोड करवाएंगे और आपकी प्रेरणा से वो 3 ट्रांजेक्शन करेगा, कभी 50 रुपए की चीज खरीदेगा, कभी 30 रुपए की खरीदेगा, कभी 100 रुपए की खरीदेगा। ये आपके द्वारा अगर हुआ है तो एक अगर आपने व्यक्ति को इसमें जोड़ा तो सरकार की तरफ से आपके खाते में 10 रुपया जमा हो जाए। अगर एक दिन में आप 20 लोगों को भी कर लें तो शाम को जेब में 200 रुपया आपके खाते में आ जाए। अगर वैकेशन के 3 महीना तय करने पे रोज 200 रुपया कमाना है, बताइए मेरे नौजवान साथियों, ये कोई मुश्किल काम है क्या आपके? सामान्य को लेना देना नहीं, उसको सिर्फ सिखाना है, समझाना है। और जो व्यापारी अपने दुकान पर भीम ऐप को लागू करेगा, कारोबार उसे शुरू करेगा, तो उसको जो सिर्फ मिनिमम जो रेट होगा उतना करेगा तो उसको 25 रुपए मिलेगा, उसके खाते में 25 रुपए जमा होगा। यानी जिसको आप समझाना है उसको समझा सकते हैं, देख मुझे तो 10 मिलवा लेकिन तेरे को 25 मिल जाएगा। और यह योजना 14 अक्टूबर तक चलेगी, बाबा साहब अंबेडकर का दीक्षा प्राप्त करने वाला दिवस था। 6 महीने हमारे पास, हर नौजवान इस वैकेशन में 10,000-15,000 रुपए आराम से कमा सकते। और आप भ्रष्टाचार के खिलाफ की लड़ाई जीतने के लिए मेरे सबसे बड़े मददगार बन जाएंगे। और इसलिए मैं आपको निमंत्रण देता हूं कि इस योजना में उसकी बारी भी जो लिखित होगी वही फाइनल। मैं समझाने के लिए थोड़ा प्लस माइनस बोल रहा हूं, लेकिन जब आप लिखित पढ़ेंगे तो पक्की योजना आपको समझ आ जाएगी। और मैं चाहता हूं, मैं देश के नौजवानों को चाहता हूं, अब एग्जाम हो गई है, मोबाइल फोन उठाइए, इस व्यवस्था को समझिए और पर डे 20 लोग, 25 लोग, 30 लोग पर लग जाएंगे। आप शाम को 200-300 रुपए कमा करके घर चले जाएंगे और पूरे वैकेशन में आप करेंगे, अगले साल के आपके खर्च पड़ेगा, पॉकेट खर्च अपने आप निकल जाएगा, कभी गरीब माँ बाप के पास से 1 रुपया मांगने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी। ये रिवॉल्यूशन लाने का प्रयास। आज यहां 75 टाउनशिप कम कैश वाले उसका लोकार्पण, इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि जहां पर टाउनशिप में लोग रहते हैं, अलग अलग फर्टिलाइजर कंपनियां की टाउनशिप है, कि रेलवे वालों की टाउनशिप है, कि फॉयल वालों की टाउनशिप है, ऐसी 75 ने पूरी तरह अपने आप को कम गैस वाला किया है। तो जब मैंने इसकी पहली ये टाउनशिप कम गैस वाली बनी तो मैं उसका प्रेजेंटेशन ले रहा था। मैंने कहा सब्जी वाले का क्या इंटरेस्ट है, वो क्यों ये कारोबार में आग लगा रहे। तो बड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग जवाब दिया सब्जी वाले। उसने कहा पहले ये जो टाउनशिप में मैं बेचने के फुटपाथ पर बैठता हूं, सब्जी बेचता हूं, तो जो महिलाएं सब्जी खरीदने आती है, अगर बिल बन गया 25 रुपए 80 पैसा तो कहते हैं लो 25 रुपए ले लो, चलो चले जाए, वो 80 पैसा नहीं देती। कितनी भी अमीर परिवार की महिला हो, बड़े से बड़े बाबू की पत्नी हो, ये 80 पैसा नहीं देती, ले लो 25 रुपए ठीक है, चलो छोटा छोटा। बोले इसकी कहानी क्या हुआ है, मुझे पूरा 25 रुपए 80 पैसा मिलता है। और बोले शाम को जो मेरा 15-20 रुपया कम पड़ जाता था, अब मेरा 15-20 रुपया मेरी एक्स्ट्रा इनकम ऐसे ही हो गई। अब देखिए कितना फायदा ये गरीब आदमी अपने पे से ढूंढ लिया। लेकिन ये 75 टाउनशिप एक अच्छी शुरुआत है। ये हम लोगों की कोशिश रहनी चाहिए कि हम कम कैश की ओर देश को ले चले, हम इसमें योगदान दें। और ये जो रिवोल्यूशन हो रहा है उसके हम स्वयं एक सिपाही बने, उस बात को हम आगे बढ़ाएं। मुझे विश्वास है कि आज जिन लोगों को इनाम मिला है और इतने कार्यक्रम में करीब 250 करोड़ से ज्यादा इनाम मिले हैं, वे इनाम प्राप्त कर करके संतोष न माने। हजारों की तादाद में नागरिकों को इनाम मिला है, वे भी इसके एम्बेसडर बने, वे भी इस काम को आगे बढ़ाएं। ये देश में परिवर्तन लाने का नागरिकों की मदद से होने वाला एक बहुत बड़ा सफल अभियान है। मैं रविशंकर जी और उनके विभाग की पूरी टीम को और नीति आयोग को बड़ी बधाई देता हूं कि फूल प्रूफ टेक्नोलॉजी के लिए उन्होंने भरसक कोशिश। दुनिया में जितने प्रकार की टेक्नोलॉजी में इनोवेशन हुए हैं, इन सारी चीजों का स्टडी, आप उसमें से उत्तम भारत में क्या हो सकता है, भारत के सामान्य मानवीय को गरीब से गरीब व्यक्ति भी इसको अपने कारोबार से चला सके। इतना यूजर फ्रेंडली विश्वस्त ये व्यवस्था विकसित हुई है। मैं फिर एक बार विभाग के सभी साथियों को बधाई देता हूं। मैं महाराष्ट्र सरकार का अभिनंदन करता हूं इस कार्यक्रम की रचना के लिए। नागपुर को उन्होंने यजमान रूप में उत्तम सेवा की, बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में आप सबसे मुझे मिलने का अवसर मिला, आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Yeah.